Welcome back to NTSC Play Super Smash Bros. Project M. Featuring myself, Spencer, my co-host, Matt, the singer, Faith, and of course, trying too hard to be the singer of Guns N' Roses.
Fox!
Got him. Let's go, Falco. I have 8 wins. I went back and I looked at the tape, and you're right, I did say Samus instead of Zelda. Think about how much integrity that I have. I could have just looked back and then never had let you know that, but you know what? I'm not that type of guy. I'm a guy who, if I'm wrong, I don't mind being wrong.
You know, I feel kind of obligated to quote one of our favorite black comedians here, Matt, in a second. Which one? Cookie? Right? You're supposed to tell the truth. No, but, you know, in all reality, Matt and I do operate on a system of totally trying to be as neutral as possible once we realize that we're wrong. Something that's hard to do for a lot of people. Some people like to argue something even if they know that they're already wrong, just for the sake of it.
Looking at you, Coulter, you piece of shit.
Some people just enjoy arguing.
I like to argue, but, you know.
I like to argue. Like, arguments are enjoyable when it's like, not quite at that level where, like, it's supposed to get real. You know what I'm saying?
I used to be really bad about that.
What, like, arguments getting too real?
No, not admitting when I was wrong. But, you know, you grow up.
I mean, I used to be pretty bad about that, too. I would always try to, like switch the situation around and make myself technically right. That was my petty way of getting through that.
Every time you do a fucking baby brother bullet, Angels loses his wings. Dude, did you see that Falco recovery, though?
It's pretty impressive for a Falco.
I laugh so I don't cry.
This music reminds me too much of Maple Story.
Oh, fucking hell.
Too low of a percent.
So I've been watching the Lethal Weapon movies. I have no idea why, but on Wednesday, I think, I was just like, I want to watch something action-y. You know what? They're not bad.
Yeah, dude, they're classics.
But what's crazy is that the second one and the third one are not like the first one at all. Because the first one, Mel Gibson character, Riggs, I'm dead. He's like on the edge. He's like, I'm gonna, like, he wants to kill himself. He, like, literally, he wants to kill himself.
Yeah.
His wife died, whatever. Mm-hmm. And he wants to kill himself. And then, you know, obviously, I'm too old for this shit, man. That's probably the cleanest pillar I've ever done.
Yeah. I mean, I don't want to take away from it, but I wasn't trying too hard to get out of here.
But they just, like, they just, and they just, like, get over the fact. They just, like.
Well, I'm sure, as it turned out, that they probably.
But he was, like, a cop on the edge. And they said that, like, 18 times in the movie. The therapist, the police therapist, like, says it, like, 100 times.
Yeah, I'm sure what happened was in the first movie, they like it was the first movie, right? And then the thing everyone liked about them was their like
duo and their comedy.
Yeah, the duo buddy cop scenario, unless like, you know, the serious drama shit. So that's probably what happened.
Yeah. Well, apparently the writer who wrote the first one, was his first script ever, and it was a lot darker and a lot like. Crazier, a lot more bloodshed, a lot more gore, like just like an all around way more crazy. Shit, and he wanted the second one to be where Riggs dies. And they do leave it up to be kind of ambiguous. Well, kind of. They shot two endings for it. One where Riggs does die and one where he doesn't.
Where it's like left unsure.
Well,
oh shit.
No, in the one that eventually went to theaters, he totally lives.
I haven't seen those movies in such a long time.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they're good. But yeah, they definitely upplay the comedy and stuff like that. And in the second movie, turns out that one of the bad guys, his henchmen, killed his wife in a thing. And then they kill his current girlfriend, too.
Shit. But he's totally fine with that, because he has his best friend.
Yeah. And in the third movie, they really drive home the fact that they're, like, buddies, like...
Like a montage of them like getting drinks and laughing.
No, Murtag.
Murtag.
Yeah.
And Thorn.
No.
Oh my God! Well, what's gonna do to Aragorn next?
Danny Glover. Donald Glover.
Danny Glover.
Accidentally, his kid's friend is in a gang. And the dude gets a Uzi, and he doesn't realize, or Murtag doesn't realize that it's his kid's friend, and kills him after he opens fire on
Murtag them. Murtag is the name of the buddy,
yeah,
the black buddy dude.
Yeah,
that's so funny. I wonder if in Aragorn, for real, like. Maybe the guy was a fan of Lethal Weapon and named
it
that.
Murtag is a pretty...
I don't think it's like a common name, dude. It's only two times I've ever heard the name Murtag. I'm just saying, like, I wonder if there's some kind of reference there where it's like...
Don't think there's a reference.
Well, because it almost feels like in the books, they could have been, like, good friends. That's all I'm saying. Continue. Yeah, he doesn't realize it's his friend, so he shoots him.
Not his kid's friend. He's yeah, 16 or something like that. Kills him. Because the kid opened fire on him. And this is in the third movie. And so he's like going through a whole bunch of shit, and he's like 6 days away from retirement.
But one last mission takes him out, and he realizes, nah, man, retirement ain't for me.
Yeah, that's true. But so he's going through that, and then you don't see him for like, I don't know, like 20 minutes in the movie, and he's on his boat, and
his son sent a hitman after him.
No. Then Riggs goes and sees him, and they talk about, well, what's his face is totally drunk, Murtag, and they have this big old heart to heart, well, not really a heart to heart, but like a
moment.
Where was his face is all drunk, and then Riggs is all like, I don't have anybody else besides you. I have three beautiful kids, and they're yours, and all those other things, and all this stuff. So they really try to drive home the fact that they're, like, symbiotic. They have a symbiotic relationship.
Yeah.
So that part's fun, and they have this gag where they don't know if they're gonna go on three or go.
Oh, that's funny. Damn it!
So they're like,
just stop floating forward. Yeah.
They're like, one, two, three, and then sometimes they'll go on three, and then sometimes they'll go on
go.
Yeah. But I started watching those movies because I remember, like, when I was really young, there's a scene, and I think it's these movies, where he gets, like, a giant saw and takes out a hovercraft.
What?
Yeah, like, those, like, ones that are on the beach or whatever, and they're, like, the skeet ball tables or whatever. It, like, floats on sand. Know what I'm talking about?
Kind of.
They're like plastic and they're filled with air.
Yeah, like a literal hover thing. I have like a little fan.
Yeah. And I don't know if it's these movies or what. But I vaguely remember Mel Gibson being in them, so I think they're the Lethal Weapon movies.
At all.
And then the third one was his face got like a badass girlfriend. That I thought the whole time, I'm like, she's going to betray them. She didn't.
She's badass.
Yeah. They're like all comparing scars with Riggs. That was a Mewtwo King angle.
Oh man. I was too afraid of getting hit. Should've just committed.
Shitty tits. That was a mix-up. Man, that was a head stomp.
Damn it. My movement got all fucked up because wow. Once you get to a certain percent, it's really hard to do anything.
Yeah.
Because every hit either sends me way far away, or like if I'm shielded, it just like I don't have time to do anything in between hits. If the stun is too long. One, go!
That was crazy. That was like some West Ball shit, dude. Let's look at the replay.
Well, I don't know what I could have done differently, but...
It sounds...
I'm just gonna go through all of them. I have to replay.
I'm trying to do the multi-shine. That was lucky.
I hate it when you want to, like, you want to tilt, so you don't worry about holding the button, but then you end up forward smashing instead, so you hold it, and then, like, it fucks you. That's what just happened to me.
What?
I went to go tilt, but, and so, like, I wasn't worried about holding the button down because I was tilting.
Which button?
The A button.
Yeah?
I wasn't worried about holding it down because I was trying to tilt.
Mm-hmm.
But I accidentally forward smashed instead. So I held the forward smash.
Mm.
So it fucked up all my timing. I was trying to go fast. It's like not what I needed to happen at that
moment.
Well,
dude, we all know what you need to do if you need to go fast. You need to play Sanic. And he's right over here.
He's actually viable. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, hit like button if you want to see some more. Subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.
Peace.